This year, St. Lucia and other members of the UN Environment Assembly agreed on a resolution to end plastic pollution and forge an international legally binding agreement by 2024. The St. Lucian government remains faithful in its commitments to address marine litter and waste management generally, progressing with a high-level meeting to develop a national source inventory on plastic pollution and marine litter and a marine litter management action plan held at the Finance Administrative Center on Thursday, 21st July 2022.
We are hosting a high-level meeting where we're bringing various stakeholders together to try and address the litter issue that we have in the country, with specific emphasis on marine litter. We have with us not just staff from the Department of Sustainable Development, but a lot of collaborating agencies. The Fisheries Department is represented here today. We have the St. Lucia Bureau of Standards. And of course, we've been supported externally by the United Nations Environment Program, otherwise known as UNEP. They are providing both technical and financial support to help us in the formation and creation of that marine litter management action plan. This has a lot of significance for St. Lucia. As you know, we are looking to transition from our traditional economic pillars and make use of the marine environment as a form of as an economic niche, so to speak, and that is why we have been giving expression to the whole notion of the blue economy. And basically, we're just looking to maximize the economic potential, as I said, that can be derived from the marine ecosystem.
The development of a national source inventory will enable officials to identify the most important sources of marine litter entering the environment, waterways, and coastal seas. The National Inventory is expected to encompass statistics and databases on product life cycles and flows, waste sources and streams, and data gathered through monitoring freshwater, wastewater, and coastal and marine environments.
We know that the issue of pollution and marine litter, plastic pollution especially, is a menace not only to St. Lucia, but to many small island developing states, and in fact the world over. It can have the, and it has the ability to affect us socially, environmentally, economically. It does not augur well for our tourism industry or for fisheries, for example. So we want to be able to look at this very closely and see, where is our waste coming from? Where are the pathways? Are we managing our waste properly? Why is it ending up in the streams and the ravines and the gutters and the drains that end up being a problem when we have heavy rainfall? So we have clogging of the drains and flooding of properties, for example. So we want to make sure, we want to determine where is everything coming from? Where is it going to? How are we managing it? What is the composition? What are the quantities of waste that we're also dealing with. So that is looking at the whole national source inventory.
Deputy Chief Sustainable Development and Environment Officer Don Pierre Nathaniel reveals that the Marine Litter Management Action Plan will require higher levels of coordination and cooperation from public and private sector stakeholders to mitigate and prevent marine litter in St. Lucia.
The Marine Litter Management Action Plan looks at the issue of coherence and coordination. There are many organizations that are involved in the management of waste in one way or the other. So it's not simply one organization, but it is the private sector, the public sector, it's civil society, it's stakeholders, it's everyone really that has a role to play. The recyclers, the supermarkets, those that produce and import various plastic items, and all of us have a role to play. So we want to ensure with the Marine Litter Action Management Action Plan that we have that coherence, we have that coordination, we know the entities and everyone knows what their roles and responsibilities are as we try to address this issue, this menace, this plague that we have in St. Lucia and in many other places in the Caribbean and in the world over.
St. Lucia's collaborative approach in the pursuit of a national source inventory on plastic pollution and marine litter and the Marine Litter Management Action Plan is supported by the United Nations Environment Program. For the DBS News World, I'm Jason Darius.